Want to be a Silicon Valley power player? That takes some pretty deep pockets. But you can be a part of the action through something called Kickstarter. And there's some kind of cool new projects out there you might want to throw some money at. And to tell us more about that, we're joined by tech writer Jessica Naziri. Hi, Jessica.
Hi, how are you?
I'm good. All right, before we get into the projects, a little bit about Kickstarter. What is it?
Kickstarter really kickstarts great ideas. Let's start it with that. It's a crowdfunding area. It's a space where people put out projects, be in the tech industry, in entertainment. You put out a project, but you don't have enough money. So you have people that pledge and you have a deadline. And if you have all the money met, you have the funds to go and put that project into fruition.
So I put that idea out there. I put some money into it. What do I get back?
So it depends. You put out a novel idea, but depending on what the project is, sometimes you have a prototype that you get. Sometimes you get to meet the creators. It depends, right? It depends on the project.
So your parents go on vacation, they bring you back a t-shirt. Bottom line. Okay, I'm being cynical. Let's look at some of the projects here. For
sure.
Example, I'm looking at something called Holovision. That sounds like it's right out of Star Trek.
Okay. This is for us geeks right here.
Okay.
It's a 3D hologram, a life-size hologram. Yes, very interesting, right? The device, it's called Holovision. It brings a human-sized floating hologram projected into 3D display. It requires no special glasses, and it literally hovers over you standing next to you.
So this is like, help me, Obi-Wan Kenobi, you're my only hope.
Yes, exactly. I mean,
and if you don't get that reference, then you're in the wrong crowd.
Exactly. I mean,
okay. What's the point? I mean, will they make movies with this? Is that the idea?
So what they want to do is they want to bring this into different industries. For example, they want to bring it to Rite Aid and have a floating coupon. So they want to start out with that and then bring it to your home as well.
Well, if this is such a good idea, how come big venture capital companies aren't throwing lots of money at them?
Well, they have gotten funding before, but they need $950,000.
Ouch.
Yes. And that's not chump change. So it's heavy equipment. It's the technology is out there. They just need the funds to make it go through.
All right, show me another one of these
Absolutely.
Things. This one's called Ivy Sleek.
Ivy Sleek. So it looks like an alarm clock, but it's a smart alarm clock. It tells you the weather. It tells you where you need to be. It gives you the traffic. It's very interesting. They actually first appeared at CES in Las Vegas. They're an LA-based company. It's smart, it's voice activated, and it brings a Siri-like personal assistant into your home.
Wait a minute, it's a smart alarm clock. We have spouses for that. Honey, wake up, you're late. Is that what it does?
Maybe a little bit more than that.
Okay.
So what happens is it connects to all your devices. So it connects to your iPhone, to your iPad. It makes your home smart.
Open the pod bay doors, Hal. Okay,
I
got that. And our last one, Bukito, I'm guessing it's not a lunch thing.
Bukito is not lunch. It's not what you had for dinner either, actually. It's a 3D printer in which you can take with you anywhere. So you want to print something 3D, you take it with you, and it's portable. You can move it around, and it still works, although the creators advise not to move it around.
There's a crying need for this?
There is a crying need. There's so many 3D devices. Now you can port it around with you.
When it comes to Kickstarter, I was seeing the other day that Spike Lee, great director, wants to raise $1.25 million for his next movie. And I'm thinking, wait a minute, this movie becomes hugely successful. He makes a bazillion dollars,
yeah.
And I get a t-shirt? I mean, what?
You can also have dinner with him, but the funding is a little expensive. Some platforms, you know, you think, like, why exactly are they going on there? You know, he has enough money. Maybe he doesn't. Who knows? But he's taking an independent route, and he's bringing people on board and making it more interactive.
Yeah, more to the point, $10,000 will get you courtside seats at a Knicks game with Spike Lee. A $5 donation, you get a tweet. Nice. Jessica Naziri has all of these things and more. You can find them at latimes.com. I'm David Lazarus. Until next time, see you in the business section.